This is the all-new 2020 Polaris Slingshot. Now, don't adjust your monitors. This is actually an all-new vehicle compared to the current 2019 model on the outside and on the inside. So, let's take a look. The Slingshot has always been a very in-your-face, visceral-looking machine, and this new 2020 model is no exception. Up front, we have new daytime running lights. They create this excellent X shape when you look at it head-on. Additionally, the center-mounted headlight is extraordinarily bright. Then, from there are some small aerodynamic tweaks. If you look closely compared to the outgoing model, the fender design is slightly different. This Slingshot R model, as compared to the other SL model, features 18-inch wheels up front and a large 19-inch wheel out back, because of course the Slingshot is a three-wheel autocycle. For the tire nerds out there, these front tires are a 225 section width wide. That rear tire is a massive 305 section width rear tire. It is enormous. And when you look at this head on from the back, I mean, it just looks huge and imposing. Coming to the side profile of the Slingshot, you notice the color palette. This particular example is black on black on black with a little bit of red. And that's where Polaris has really diversified the Slingshot for 2020. Because while if you look down here, these lower portions are all unpainted plastic. That's standard across the lineup. Up here, you have this nice gloss black finish. And you can get these panels in a wide range of colors for 2020 to really customize the look of your Slingshot, which is a big thing Polaris is really pushing, the customizable aspect of this vehicle. While you may have thought the front of the Slingshot looks wild, the rear is where things get especially crazy, because obviously the Slingshot is a three-wheeler. So you come back here and you see a motorcycle-style single-sided swing arm which rolls into this giant 19-inch wheel. Obviously, it creates a really cool visual effect that the whole thing kind of tapers off back here. And you see just how wide the Slingshot actually is. I mean, it's almost as wide as a full-size vehicle. Perhaps the biggest change for 2020 is what's under the clamshell hood of the new Slingshot. Now, opening the hood is a bit of a process, so bear with me. Pop the latch under the Polaris emblem, pull it forward and down with two hands. Now this is the real party favor of the new Slingshot. It's an all new engine. It's a 2-liter inline 4-cylinder engine from Polaris ProStar engine family. Hardcore off-roaders may know that Polaris offers a 2-cylinder, 1-liter version of this in the Razor off-road side-by-side machine. But this is twice the size, and unsurprisingly, it has twice as much horsepower. This thing produces 203 horsepower at 8,500 RPM, so it's a real screamer of an engine. Now, if you want the base model Slingshot SL, you get the same engine, but it's detuned to produce 178 horsepower. Sitting inside the Slingshot, it's kind of a mixed bag. Polaris went on at great lengths about how they've improved the cabin and made this a much more livable and refined space. But at the end of the day, it's still a Slingshot, right? So looking in front of you, while I think that the steering wheel is really nice, the shifter's quite nice and seats are quite nice. All the touch points, which is something they really worked on. The rest of it is pretty low rent. So it's a lot of cheap plastic. They did go to the lengths of painting this center trim here, which looks kind of nice. It's color matched to this structural roll cage. There are nice touches in here. Again, they focus on the touch points of the car, what you interact with. But taken as a whole, it looks pretty cheap, especially for almost $33,000. On the up and up, Polaris has improved the standard content you do get in the Slingshot. Looking in front of me, I have a digital display inside two analog gauges for the speedometer and tachometer. And this steering wheel, which I do actually like, has a lot of buttons on it. They're big, chunky buttons, so you can press them quite easily when you're wearing driving gloves, which in this car, especially in the winter, you'll probably want to be doing. Looking at these buttons, you have the kind of normal things you'd expect. You have the stereo controls over here, but over here you have your screen display, so you can toggle your screen in the center stack, as well as your cruise control. But in the middle of them all is a big red button. What does that do? Well, that engages the different drive modes this thing has, which is a new feature for 2020. This thing has two different drive modes, Comfort and Slingshot. And Polaris put a lot of emphasis on the slingshot mode as being the true slingshot experience. Take that as you will. It recalibrates things like the throttle mapping. In the case of the automatic transmission, it recalibrates that as well. Does it really make that much of a difference? I'm not so sure, but it does feel very cool pushing the big red button and engaging slingshot mode. Beyond that, Polaris said they recognize what people want in this thing. Because if you are going to drive it on the road, you do want some modern conveniences. So this thing has multiple spots where there are USB ports to plug in your phone. And indeed, you can pair your phone to the central infotainment system. It's not quite full Android Auto or Apple CarPlay, but you have that level of integration. So if you want to play your music on here on the Rockford Fosgate audio, which is very, very loud, appropriate when you're driving 60 miles an hour with no roof on, you can do that. And speaking of this infotainment system, it's of Polaris' own design. The big chunky buttons are a central theme here. I actually do like the layout of this infotainment system. It's very simple and there are some touch elements. So on this screen, you can configure what it shows you. And you do that kind of like by a phone. You click, drag, and drop, which is a pretty cool feature. So I mentioned touch points before. Touch points are things you actually interact with in this cabin, and I love the seats in this thing. There are these deeply bolstered, racy looking bucket seats that are actually quite comfortable. But more than that, they fold forward. And that becomes important in just a second. When you fold the seats forward, you can see these storage cubbies. Behind both of the seats are these large, deep storage bins. They are surprisingly deep and able to fit a lot of stuff and a lot of gear in here, which is really great and very useful. Now we can talk about the stats and the figures and the way this thing looks all day. But all that matters is how it makes you feel when you're driving it, because the Slingshot is really meant to be driven. And it's a really visceral, full-on experience, just like the way it looks. This test car has the 5-speed manual, though it's worth noting an automated manual, an automatic, is now available for 2020. That's one of the big headlines here. Regardless, the manual's great. The clutch is really nice to use. The shifter has a nice, really positive feel to it. The gear spacing is excellent. And it really allows you to take advantage of that new engine, which is just so exciting. I mean, it revs to 8,500 RPM and just sounds great. I mean, just as you would expect, fully optioned out, this thing only weighs 1,640 pounds, according to Polaris. And so when you give that lightweight body 203 horsepower, is gonna make for a pretty exciting ride. Polaris says it has 0 to 60 in 4.9 seconds, and it absolutely feels every second of it. Perhaps less important than the 0 to 60 sprint is the way it drives, because in these corners, it's really exciting. The steering is very communicative. You can really feel what those front tires are doing. Slightly less communicative, but no less fun, is that big rear tire. This thing has traction control, and if you turn it off, it is off. This thing will do crazy burnouts if that's what you're into. But at the same time, if you turn traction control back on, it's very controllable and very approachable. It's very easy to get in this car and drive it quickly. Another reason why this thing is pretty easy to drive quickly is the suspension. I touched on it before, but that rear suspension is a big motorcycle swing arm with coilover shocks. The front end has double wishbone suspension with adjustable coilover shocks. It's very compliant. Now, it's definitely not soft, but it is compliant. So the ride is definitely firm, but it absorbs the bumps in such a way that it makes you very assured it's gonna hang on and the grip is there. Now, beyond the dynamics, which are hilarious fun, Polaris says that about 1 in 3 people who buy these things are using them as everyday drivers. I'm not so sure about that, but I guess if you just drive around town at low speed, it might be possible. It might be doable to use this every day if you have a really short commute. Now, another facet why I think this isn't exactly daily driver material is the wind noise. The buffeting is very, very intense, as you'd expect from a vehicle with no roof and a very short little windshield. I mean, I'm wearing a helmet, which is not necessarily required by law, depending on where you live, but it's absolutely required because the amount of buffeting you're gonna get in this cabin, which I guess is fitting, because Polaris said, don't think of the Slingshot as a car. Don't even think of it as a motorcycle. It's a machine. It's the Slingshot. And this experience is definitely a Slingshot experience in the way that only a Slingshot can deliver. Though, you have to wonder, what can you compare this with? The first two things that come to mind are the Can-Am Spyder and a Vanderhall. But neither of those two vehicles feel quite as racy, I should say, as this thing does. The spirit of the Slingshot is kind of its own thing. So I suppose the lack of innate competition is a good thing, because then it makes it easier to stomach the price. The base price of the Slingshot SL with a detuned 178 horsepower engine automatic transmission is $26,500, which is a lot. This Slingshot R with the Go Fast engine is over $30,000. It's a lot of money for a toy, but it's a lot of toy. It's a lot of fun. So if you're interested in a Polaris Slingshot, which I imagine if you're watching this video, you probably are, you can learn more by clicking the link down below and going to autobytel.com. Because man, this thing is a lot of fun.